Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, sweet Holy Spirit of the living God. Thank you, Father, for fellowship with you. Thank you for the anointing of the Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit, because you teach us more about you. And we go deeper and deeper and deeper in the love of God. In Jesus' name. Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Folajimila Waltemtope. I'm here to speak to us about the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is the third person of the Trinity. The Bible says, and Jesus speaking said, in the book of John chapter 16 verse 14, the Bible says that he will glorify me, for he will take what is mine and declare it to you. Jesus Christ was speaking, he was talking about the Holy Spirit. He said he will take what is his and declare it to us. As a believer, as a Christian, you are supposed to know things about God. You're supposed to know the things of God. The Bible says that set your minds on the things above and not beneath. It is the Holy Spirit that will help you to know these things. How do you search the heart of God? How do you know the heart of God? It's by the Spirit of God. Jesus Christ needed the Holy Spirit so much in his ministry. The Bible says in Acts 10:38, it said, our God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with power and the Holy Spirit. And he went about doing good. Jesus needed the Holy Spirit to go about to do good. So when you have the Holy Spirit, you have the liberty, you have the ability, you have the capacity to go about to do good. The Holy Spirit gives you the ability of God. Meaning divinity begins to work in you. Jesus Christ said, he said in the book of John chapter 14 verse 26, he said, but the helper, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name. So it is in the name of Jesus that the Holy Spirit comes. When you receive the Holy Spirit, when you're about to receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit, it's by faith in Jesus Christ. He said, in my name, he will teach you all things. So when you have the Holy Spirit, you know all things. The Bible says that I have the unction of the Holy One, therefore I know all things. This thing has worked for me in my life. It has worked for me in my exams in schools. It has worked for me in every spheres of my life. It says it will remind you of all things. It will show you the things to come. It will show you the deep things of God. You can only get closer to God. You can only go deeper in fellowship with the Father by the Spirit of God. You can only know the love of God by the Spirit. The Bible says that the love of God is shed abroad in our heart by the Holy Ghost. When you have the Holy Spirit, you are full of joy and you have the love of God in you. You begin to dwell in the abundance of God's love. You cannot really explain the love of God. You can only encounter it. And the Holy Spirit can make you encounter the love of God. Jesus speaking in the book of John chapter 4, when he was by the well and he met the woman, the Samaritan woman, she came to meet Jesus Christ. She said to Jesus that, what was this water he was talking about? Because Jesus Christ said, he said, if you drink of my own water that I'm going to give to you, he said, you will never thirst again. Glory to God. The Bible records a believer that out of your belly will flow rivers of living waters. The Holy Ghost, Sunday Shandala Barabashata. Glory to God. Glory to God. When God told, when Jesus told the woman at the well, he said, I will give you living water. Jesus was talking about giving her the Word of God, the Holy Spirit, and salvation. When you have those three things, you have everything. When you have the Word of God, when you have the Holy Ghost, when you have salvation, you become a family of eternity. You come into eternal life. Oh, Jesus Christ. This is the life that we've been called into. The life of God. The God kind of life. It is the Holy Spirit that helps you to live this kind of life. It is the Holy Spirit that reveals Jesus Christ to you. He said, Apostle Paul understood the ministry of the Holy Spirit. He understood the passion he had for Christ. He understood the revelation he needed about Jesus. He said that I may know you more and the power of your resurrection. The power of your resurrection. The Holy Spirit is the power that quickened Jesus Christ at his resurrection. It's the power of God. The Bible says that the same Holy Spirit that raised Jesus from the dead, glory to God, is on your inside, lives in you. He says it shall quicken your mortal bodies. Glory to God. Mandei shandalabayadaba. I have the Holy Ghost. I'm conscious of the Holy Spirit. I recognize the Spirit of God. I acknowledge the Holy Spirit as my teacher. I have the power of God on my inside because the Holy Spirit is in me. It says in the last days I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and daughters shall prophesy, your old men shall dream dreams, and your young men shall see visions. In the last days, brethren, the last days started in the book of Acts chapter 2. Glory to God. When the apostles received the Holy Spirit, the Bible says that the Holy Ghost came like a sound of a mighty rushing wind, and it filled the old house. Mandei shandala baralo shande. The people began to speak in the Holy Ghost. They began to speak in other tongues. The Bible says that the people around thought they were filled with new wine. Oh, Jesus, there is a new wine. There is a new wine. The new wine of the Spirit. Ephesians 5:18. Do not be drunk with wine wherein it's excess, but be filled with the Spirit. Be filled with the Spirit. How do you get filled with the Spirit? You sing in tongues. You sing in tongues. You sing in tongues. You get filled with the Spirit. You make melodies in your heart. Oh, thank you, Jesus. You go deeper and deeper. You go deeper and deeper. You don't care about the things of the world. You are filled with the Spirit. Thank you, Jesus. This is the place of God. This is our inheritance in Christ Jesus. The Holy Spirit is our friend. You need to begin to see the Holy Spirit as your friend. You need to begin to see the Holy Spirit as your partner. The Bible says our body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. He's in you. Yes, he's in you. I love him so much. When I say I love him, I'm not even sure anymore. I love him so much. And he's revealing Jesus to me. He's revealing the Savior to me. He's revealing the love of the Father. The Bible says that for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. For God so loved the world. You need to understand this love. You need to know this love. The Bible says that you may know the love of Christ. You may know the love of the Anointed One and his anointing. Then you will come into the fullness of God. There is something called the new wine. The Holy Spirit is amazing. The Holy Spirit can show you the things to come. The Holy Spirit can show you the things to come. When you begin to fellowship with the Spirit of God, you come into a personal relationship with God. You begin to know the heart of the Father. You begin to know the things that pleases the Father. You begin to want to love the Father more. You begin to get more hungry. In this kingdom, as you begin to know things, you get more hungry. You get more hungry for the things of the Spirit. Oh, thank you, Lord Jesus. Whatever you need in life, whatever you think you need in life, is in Christ Jesus. The woman at the well had several husbands. No one could satisfy her. She wasn't able to be satisfied by men. But our satisfaction came from the Lord. I'm here to encourage somebody today. The things you think you're bothered about are not the things that you need. Because there's a place in your heart that hungers for God, that wants to reach out for God. And God is willing, He's willing to give you everything. Just surrender everything to Him. Just love Him more. Just love God. The secret is to love God. Jesus Christ said, as the Father loved me, I also have loved you. Abide in my love. There is a love of Christ. There is a love of Christ. There is a love of Jesus Christ that we need to understand, that notwithstanding the situations around us, the challenges that we face, there is someone that is willing to pour out His love on us. If you've been rejected, if you have been let down, if your friends have refused you, if your parents have abandoned you, I'm here to tell you that there is someone reaching out to you, always reaching out to you, for you to love Him. Thank you so very much for listening to today's episode on revealing the Spirit of God. I pray that as you listen to this video, that the Holy Spirit is revealed to you. And even after you listen to this video and you watch this video, that in the name of Jesus, you begin to encounter the supernatural. That you begin to know God even more and more every day. And you will enjoy your Christian life. Christianity is fun. You just need to know the Holy Spirit. He reveals just one person, Jesus Christ. I love Him. I love Jesus. Thank you very much. I will plan, and I pray the Holy Spirit helps me, that we may continue in this and listen to more on revealing the Spirit of God. Thank you very much. God bless you.